me clip. Yes, yes, YouTubers, welcome back to the channel. Mikey Lee from OP Gamers here, and we've got another little cheeky true Godmode glitch. As always, if you rate this video, please leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Right, now for the setup. We're pretty much going to be doing the same setup as the last Godmode glitch that we recorded. But only this time, you don't have to open the Kepler system. You want to finish round 1 in the starting room, and then pick up Neil's head and start raiding the ticket stands. If you're having a problem finding any of the ticket stands, I left a few short clips to help you to find all 6 locations around the map. Now, for this glitch, you're going to need to purchase a rewind grenade, which can be found at the far left side of any of the ticket stands. But the rewind grenade will only spawn at 1 or 2 other spots every 10 rounds. Now, once you have located your rewind grenade, you need to start collecting coins to build a trap and start raking in enough points to open both doors blocking access to the arcade. I advise using the fake card Scope Dollars so you can start point building effectively and open all locations you're going to need for the glitch. You're only going to need 2,500 points to open the first door and the second door blocking access to the Astrocade. And you're going to want to turn on the power so you can glitch out the trap on the arcade machine. And we're pretty much ready to go. I just need to get the last coin to acquire a trap. Remember, when you're building your trap, the only trap that you cannot use is the window laser trap. So avoid using blue, red, and then you'll be okay. After you've acquired your trap, I recommend thinning out the zombies so it makes it much easier when you're trying out the glitch. I find the best way to do this is take out all the zombies barring 2 or 3 until you're ready to glitch out the trap. Then go grab your rewind grenade and we're ready to crack on with the glitch. Right, first before we get started, I'd just like to say a big thank you to Neil the Robot, clan tag HOF. If you want to go check out some of his beatboxing videos, I'll be leaving some links in the description below. Right, back to the glitch. Glitching out the trap. You want to pull the trap out before you approach the arcade machine. Now approach the arcade machine and hover your trap over the top. Quickly put away your trap and hold X for a brief time, and then quickly pull your trap back out again. If you've done this incorrectly, you will still have the ball in your hand when you exit the trap. But if you do this correctly, you will hear the noise from the arcade machine, but you will not have the ball in your hand, you will have the trap. The only way to check if you've done this properly is to then again pull out your trap, and you will see the animation for when you glitched out the trap in the previous step, and you will have the ball in your hand, and you will see the logo for the ticket machine in the right corner of your screen. Right, onto the last step. This part can prove quite tricky when you're trying it out in solo, as it is much harder to avoid the zombies when you're trying to get into the glitch. So if you think the zombies are too close and you're not going to have enough time to do the glitch, simply put your trap away and repeat the process of glitching out the trap. I highly recommend grabbing yourself a banshee and shooting both of the zombies in the legs so you create a crawler and it makes it much easier. I'm sorry about the long description, I'm just trying to go through the glitch in as much detail for you guys so it makes it a lot easier for you all if you're trying this one out. After you've glitched out your trap, I find it's best to hold the zombies in this part here while you wait for Neil to approach the location where we're going to be trying the glitch. As Neil approaches the left side of the bridge as you're facing towards spawn, you're going to want to approach him and stop him in this location here. Make sure you go all the way up until you are touching him, and then go backwards and then forwards 4 to 5 times. And then walk backwards until Neil starts to move again, place the trap and then click your rewind grenade. If you do this correctly, the ticket machine animation will activate and you will still have the rewind grenade and the original trap in your hand. Honestly, words can't express how overpowered this glitch is, so I recommend you guys try it out straight away before it gets patched. I just thought I'd play this bit of gameplay again so you can get used to timing a bit better. As long as you go back on the 4th or 5th time and plant your trap as soon as Neil starts moving, you should be alright with this one. But again, if any of you are having a problem with it, just give us a message in the comment section and I'll try to help you out as soon as possible. And when you're using this one, you're immune to all traps, brutes, clowns, and even the alien blaster, as long as you don't Use a rewind grenade as it will pull you straight back out of the glitch and you won't be in true god mode and you can still get harmed by the trap. As you can see in the game footage here, after I use the rewind grenade, I'm still in god mode until I walk into the trap. So you are immune to the alien blasters until you use the rewind grenade again. And that's it from me. I hope you've all enjoyed the video, and if you did, as always, smash that thumbs up button, it really helped me out. I'd just like to say a special thanks to KD from Unit 7 and then Kato for letting me use their instrumentals, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.